Hello, dear viewer of SSBC. This is SSBC Power House with Akuch Makel, just to conduct the first ever national elections in 2015. But the sudden eruption of 2013 civil war interrupted the process. Following the signing of the revitalized peace agreement in September 12, 2018, between the government and the opposition parties, extension hopes have been reignited among the people of South Sudan to have the right to vote for leaders of their choice, as the National Elections Commission has already publicly announced mobilizing funds for conducting elections in December 2024. With the process still finding its feet, we are now joined by the chairperson of the National Elections Commission, Professor Abednego Akok Kashua. 12 years after independence without holding elections in the country, what are you working on as electoral body?
Well, we are working on three main issues which are very important for the election to be run successfully. The first of them is pre-election activities. This involves the premises of the headquarters where we are in. We are hiring, and we have not paid the landlord for the last 3 years. He is now before court, and we are in a situation of being evicted in this place. Another issue is the 10 states plus 3 administrative areas. There were offices which were established in 2014, but at the moment it seems some of them have been evicted from their offices. Some of them deserted their places, so we are now planning to visit 10 states to see practically the existence of the offices or the infrastructure there, and then to reconstitute the offices, the committee in each state. These are issues we are trying to explore at the moment. Again, we are planning to see to that means of movement for the commission are available. These are free election activities.
Okay, talking of finances, you have just confirmed that you have a pending case now in the court regarding the rent of this place. And recently you had gone to the Ministry of Finance asking for the money, that the bill that was passed for election. Have you received that money?
No, we have not received that money. Discussion is on the way now between us and those of the Minister of Finance. In fact, we are still in the cluster, being headed by the first vice president, and discussions were not ending. So another sitting is supposed to take place on the 7th of this month, and we will discuss with them about the budget. But the budget, some of them claim it is too huge, but we, the people who are going to run the election, we are saying it is very, very little. And plus the inflation we are witnessing in the country, after 4 months, this money will be less than that, because the cost will go up, and the needs will be there, but no money at hand. Furthermore, our experience with Minister of Finance for the last 10 years, we don't get half of the budget. But what we are discussing now is election budget, which means the funds should be available to be ready to flow without any inconsistency. Otherwise, this will affect the election results.
Okay, for the last 10 years, it has been hard to get your own budget for the as a commission. And now we have less than 12 months to conduct election. So confirm with us, is the country going to hold its election this year?
Well, this is political. I am a technical person. What I know is that when there are resources, within a very short time, we can complete what we need to do. But if there are no resources, and the resources, as you know, they come from the government.
You're saying it's political. But you are the commissioner here.
Yes.
Have you been given go ahead by the parties involved to conduct the election?
Yes, I just met the president 2 weeks ago, and I discussed with them the issues we are now discussing here. And I told him that you declare election is there as the leader of this nation to support the election.
So should we just say the commission has said there will be election but has not declared the election?
No, there are two different things here, my dear. The general acceptance of the election yes. by the nation mm-hmm. has already been declared by the ruling parties. Yes. And the agreement says 60 days before the end of the agreement, mm-hmm. election must be run. Hence, it is their role to see to it that this particular institution mm-hmm. is given facilities to conduct election, fair, free and credible election.
Okay, now that the country has set that in mind, that the election will take place this year, have you formed bodies that will monitor the electoral process?
We would like to establish our presence in the 10 states plus 3 administrative areas, practically. And then from there, the bodies or the people who are going to conduct civic and voter education will follow.
We are all aware that the census has not taken place. How are you going to conduct election without census?
In 2015, I consulted some experts, asking them, what are we going to do if there is no census? Their advice was that what you will do, apply voter registration, and which I did. But later on, the election was postponed in 2015. But that was the theory.
So are you going to use the same mean?
Definitely, we are going to use the same. Because that is the only mechanism we can use now.
One of the functions of the Election Commission is to recruit qualified personnel. Have you started the recruitment process? And under which, what criterions are you using?
No recruitment at the moment, my dear. Because you don't recruit without resources. You know very well now we are here, and I don't know whether you in your ministry, we are here now for about 4 months or 5 months without salary.
Professor, you seem to be dwelling too much in finances, and this one is one of the major things that should give you a go-ahead. What exactly should be done then with this issue of finances? The finance ministry is not availing the funds, and you have work that has stuck because you, based on what you're saying now, you have to have the capital to go ahead with even the bodies.
I am happy that you sat in my office and you saw the circumstances I was in. We have already electoral calendar which we have made. And if you see the timetable here, time has already gone. It should have been done right now. And then we go forward. All these things, they are theoretically available, but the practical part of it needs resources. So, as you are here now, we have now done two things. We had a Zoom meeting with the states, and that was organized by the UNMIS, and I thank them very much for that. They brought the 10 states, and we saw to it that the infrastructure there is completely nil. And then one advantage which we can thank the president, he wrote to the governors asking them to offer government houses to be used as election offices. I am very happy and very proud with my dear friend from Eastern Equatoria. He replied and he said he has offered a building to the election high committee in his state. Only very small maintenance is going to take place, then they'll get in. So, if this is done by all the governors in 20 states, we'll have no problem at all.
That means you are confirming that you have started the demarcation of the constituencies, the country?
No, we did not demarcate the constituencies. There is now a consultation between the Election Commission and the Executive about the 332 seats. Mm-hmm. In the past, there were all 102. If you divide this, you will get 16 will be for the five to be appointed by the president. Mm-hmm. And you go on, you will get 156 mm-hmm. seats. Mm-hmm. They have no constituencies. Hence, a decision must be made by the executive or by the parliament mm-hmm. to see to that the old constituencies are restructured again to fit this number. Yes.
Everyone must be asking who is eligible to vote in this coming election in South Sudan, and when are they going to be registered?
Very good question. You know, as I just told you a few minutes ago, we are to begin this month. We are to begin with the civic and voter education. They are continuous. They will go on. But the actual voter registration should start in March or April.
March or April.
Yes.
That is good. Not far. March or April. That is some days to March.
That's right.
So, does the army have the right to vote? If yes, will they vote in barrack or where?
Well, a polling station will be made anywhere. Then they can
go there.
The first thing is they want to register their names. That is the first one. And then the polling station should be put here, near them. They can come and cast their votes. Because they are citizens of South Sudan.
Okay, what do you people do now as a commission, since you have very limited time to election?
This election work is an individual work. The sovereignty is now given to the citizens to elect their own people. So they should work up and assist us. When people go for voter education, they will immediately understand that the right has been maintained for them. Hence, they are to be ready for registration. Once you register your name, that is the right you are going to do. You vote for a person you like to represent you in the national parliament.
So the registration that will be done at the state level, administrative area, wherever you are,
yes.
Or must you, like I'm somebody from Jonglei, must I go to Jonglei to register, or I can register here?
No. Once you are living in Juba town, and you have been here for the last 6 months, you have the right to be registered. And you have the right to vote here. Yes.
So far, do we know the political parties contending, and have you ever met them as a commission?
Well, I usually meet with the chairman of the political parties council, and we discuss so many issues. He has now opened the registration of political parties. They should register now before time could come.
But so far, how many have registered?
I'm not sure, but I will consult them. It just started last week. Yes.
Okay, let's take a look at what Professor Akech posted on 29th of January, that, and I quote, election, called the election nonsense, an ethnically composed, politically aligned, poorly trained, and a resource army cannot be relied upon to be professional nor politically neutral during the conduct of elections. This country is not ripe for a democratic transition. What message does it carry?
I heard of that, but I read something which he wrote later, I think 3 days ago, where he accepts that election should be conducted.
So is Professor confusing people because he's the vice chancellor of a big institution?
What I read last 2 days, he accepts election should be conducted. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is what I read. Mm-hmm. And it is in the office now. And what he said, that is his individual opinion. Mm-hmm. And that's why we like there should be a political space. Anybody can say anything. Mm-hmm. And people should tolerate him. Mm-hmm. But he's a vice chancellor of a very important university. This university assists the movement by that time. 85 women were here. It is this university which activates the movement very, very seriously. For him as a vice chancellor, that is his opinion. But what I thought he should propagate for is there should be transfer of power. In my speech which I delivered before the president, I said this is a chance to move from militarization to democratic process. This is what needs to be encouraged by any degree person. Let us have our government, government which we form by using our own votes. It is ours. By doing so, you believe there is no way only through democratic process. And as you rightly put it, he's the vice chancellor. And I thought university with my parents should be the right place at the moment, propagating for the election to be conducted and to be fair, free, and credible. This is the function of the university. And in that university.
Okay, how far would the permanent constitution making process to guide elections?
Well, these are two important issues. At the moment, those who are monitoring peace, they are here in Juba, and they allowed the time to go until the election commission was reconstituted. They should have kept advising the government that time is running. This constitution should have been done 2024 or 25 this way, but from 2018 until now, nothing has been done. Now they are going together. But for me, I thought the 2011 constitution is the one which can guide the election. Yes, Article 197 in the constitution is the one which nominates the election commission to be reconstituted.
So the country is going to use the temporary constitution for election?
Definitely. They are going to use the transitional constitution for the election. As I quote now, Article 197 says election should be conducted. Yes. And the board should be established, the commission.
That means after the election, that's when you will embark on the permanent constitution.
To my thinking as an academician, I think the time for election is very tight, and the time for commission constitution is very lengthy. Constitution making process, it has stages to go. So those stages should go. Meanwhile, election should be guided by the transitional constitution, Article 197, and should come and constitute a parliament which will pursue and will conduct or will establish or make a constitution we will be part of later on.
All right, dear view of SSBC, we are taking a short break. Stay tuned, we'll be back with more details with the chairperson of the National Elections Commission, Professor Abenego Akokashual. Stay tuned. So most of the provision of the agreement, like resettlement of refugees and internal displaced person, is yet effective. Any plan of repatriating the refugees to the country?
Well, I don't know much about this. But what I know, the refugees, they can be met by the government and talk to them and tell them that we can come, we can return home. Because your presence there is very important to cast your vote there. I think this one is very important for the nation. To see it without our brothers and sisters who are in the neighboring countries should be told to come back, come and practice their political right and establish a government of their own.
Is there any other option for those who are outside the country whereby they can register, or are they not allowed to vote wherever they are?
Well, we will discuss this with the political parties to know the reaction than the government. It is good to consult them, and there are areas where you can allow them to register and they can vote there. This one is possible.
Well, the constitution is allowed to vote outside the country?
The constitution doesn't allow that. But with this insecurity, the people left the place for their own safety. And when they went there, they discovered that life there is better than life in Juba. So you can now see the displaced in Unamis, very near here. They come and stay outside. In the evening, they go back. But if they are told, come and leave the Unamis around here, they will not. Yes.
Yeah, you have just mentioned about security. So, and the election is taking place. So how possible is it with these insecure places? How will the voters vote?
Well, as I just told you in my speech, when we were being sworn in, I mentioned three challenges, which are owed by the government. One of them is the political will about the election to be conducted. That is the will of the political parties plus the government. Two, the availability of resources to run the election. Three is the security arrangement. Security is a function to be made or conducted by the government. And it is good that you have mentioned it, and that's why we like media, so that people can hear that this is what is being said. These things are there, these three challenges are there, but they can be overcome when people are very serious to overcome them.
What does that mean?
What it means is that the unification of the forces should be done immediately, and the repatriation of the displaced should be done. Then avail resources to the election commission as soon as possible.
Okay, since you have presented all those things on the desk, and you are saying there is no response yet, what message can you tell the government for them to work on this with immediate effect?
Well, I think I told them several times, and I talked to the media several times. And I just talked to you now a few minutes, a second ago.
The Minister?
Yes.
Finance?
Yes. Mm-hmm. That the Minister of Finance, or those who were in finance, until now, they have never met even half of our budget, normal budget. But the budget we are talking about now is the election budget, which is different from the normal routine budget being financed by the Minister of Finance. So the availability of resources is to be discussed with presidency and the Minister of Finance.
Okay, what is the response from the Ministry of Finance, since this one should be treated as a most effective one that should be solved, but yet there's no response? Is it the resources, the finances, that the country doesn't have the money, or is the ministry treating it as an option? What?
Well, I don't know exactly why are we behaving like this, but what I know, always there should be a priority. And I thought our priority as South Sudanese is this transfer of power. This transfer of power is one of the first and important priority to be considered by all the government institutions. And then, if it is a priority, they should avail resources to enable the commission to embark on their work. So, people, I am very sorry to tell you this. Today is the 5th. And you can see from December until now we have been talking. And if you see now the environment here, the environment is so poor in it. And that's why we are talking outside. Otherwise, we should have talked inside. Practical example.
Power.
So I would really suggest to our dear Minister of Finance and his colleagues, and I am very pleased with the Cabinet Affairs Minister. He is a very wise person and a very committed person to national matters. And he is very concerned now. He made a lot of moves in the cluster, and in the next meeting, I think he will again play a very big role. And I think what is very important now is the general concern that we are going to conduct election. If we are going to do election, let us be concerned. If you are concerned, give your advice. Give us support. Let us move ahead. And I will tell them that I don't need money. If they are very serious, they hire a plane. I go to Rumbek. I go to Yambio. I come back. They pay that man. That will be the best for me. And my dear sister, our nation, we are ready to serve it. On condition that the real procedures are to be followed. That is, we have made a budget. This budget, not us alone. In Kenya, in Uganda, the election money is just put all in their account. They have no other reason to say we are late. The money is there, they can move at the time they feel like. But I was here, I don't know what is the matter.
So with this interview, the public will see. Does it mean the Ministry of Finance is contributing to the delay of election in the country? Because if you are not given the budget, you cannot move. Should the public say the ministry is contributing to the delay of elections?
Well, you see, let us wait and see. Give them a chance of another week and see.
Because you have given them now all, is it from December after February? So the ministry should be in a position now to finalize on giving you the budget as a priority for you to move. So in short, you are not doing anything until the budget is released to you.
Yes. As I told you, we have done now two things. Mm-hmm. Which were supported.
The one that doesn't need money.
Supported by the UN, UNMIS. Mm-hmm. The Zoom we did with the 20 states was organized by them. Mm-hmm. And then a workshop. Induction workshop was conducted in Pyramid, organized by the United Nations. And I thank them very much for that good work. And we are cooperating with them. But yet, another condition which the UN put forward with the other world organizations here, they say that let the government deposit something to the commission. Then from there we will give money.
Let's say the international communities, right? They are ready to come in to help, but under the condition that the government should inject
money.
Some percentage.
Yes.
So that it is confirmed if they are serious.
Exactly.
For the election.
Exactly.
And that message has reached the ministry.
Definitely.
And above.
For the election.
How long should deployment of unified forces take before election commences? Do you have any idea?
I don't have an idea about that. That is purely a security matter of the government.
Not a concern of the commission as well?
It is, as I mentioned to you before, one of the challenges I told you is security. It is a function to be organized by the government.
So it's a concern, yet they cannot tell you when?
No, they cannot tell
you. That you include in your plan?
Well, now we have the arrangement with the local security from the police. They are now being trained. And we include them in the budget, that the police should be so much concerned. The army will protect outside, but inside, the security is to be controlled by the police.
Do you have any message to the citizen of this country regarding the upcoming election? Any message for them?
The message for them is very clear, and I usually say that you are given a chance now. You are told that the sovereignty will go to you, the citizen. Catch that one well. When people go to you, listen to them well, and then register your name. When you register your name, you have won your sovereignty halfway. And then when time of polling comes, you go. You cast your vote. You cast your vote, that means you are electing a representative to come to the parliament. So that chance should not be... missed by the citizens of this country. Let them welcome.
Dear view of SSBC Power Hours with Akuch Maker, we have now come to the end of our interview with the chairperson of the National Election Commission, Professor Abednego Akol-Kachol, who was here telling us what are the preparation ahead of the 2024 general election that will take place in less than 12 months, should I say 10 months? We are yet to find out because the budget has not been released. But without budget, the status of the election remains unpredictable, right?